How you doing? You have any questions?
Just listening.
You just listening? All praises.
You just put me on task. I got mouthpiece. I'm not going
to
run.
All praises. Come here there, sis. We not trying to put nobody on blast.
He ran, though.
He ran because we were trying to teach him. Our people don't want to learn. That's the problem. Our people don't want to learn what it means to know God, what it means to love God, how to come back to God's law, statutes, and commandments. Do you know your nationality? No? No, right? You're other, right? You put other, or if you were to put something, it would be black, right? Or African American, right? You don't put that, because that's not your nationality. Watch this.
Hey, hold on.
Give me Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 3.
Bring it up.
Because you just told me you don't know your nationality. But according to the Bible, that's prophecy.
Right.
You fit the prophecy of the people of the book.
That's right.
You
have to
teach that. Isaiah.
That's right.
Chapter 1 and verse 3.
Yeah.
The ox knows his owner. Uh-huh. So God said an ox knows his owner, right? The owner feeds the ox, takes care of the ox, right? He knows who his owner is. He knows who feeds him, right? And the ass is master's crib. And an ass, meaning a donkey, knows where he stays. He knows his master's crib. You understand? He can always find his way back there, right?
But Israel!
But who?
But Israel!
But who?
But Israel!
Israel, meaning the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans who are on this line right here, right? They don't know who they are.
Right?
Read.
My people does not consider.
God calls us his people.
Right.
And we do not consider that we are God's people.
That's
we don't even care.
Right.
That's why the brother walked off.
Right.
He don't want to know. I never said you didn't. But he don't want to know.
That's something
else. He don't want to know. But what I was showing you is that you fit the prophecy, sis.
Right.
You understand?
That's right.
You are an Israelite according to the Bible.
That's right.
That's right.
You understand? Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Bring it out.
Because according to the Bible, things would happen to us if we did not keep God's commandments.
Bro,
did you know that it was a sin to be wearing pants, sis? You laugh. But it's not funny.
Bring it out, huh?
Because if you look at the conditions of our neighborhood and our people getting shot down in the street,
bro,
that is of God.
That's right.
Did you know that? Because we do not keep his commandments.
That's right.
So when you see a black man get shot right there, because you are not keeping the commandments, you are the reason why.
That's right.
You understand? Give me that in Zechariah 11 and 5. Let's show it.
So I'm supposed to wear a dress.
You are supposed to wear a dress.
That's right.
Do you see the sister right here? You see that dress she has on? That's the way our people are supposed to dress. Our sisters.
That's right.
Because our sisters are supposed to be dressed in modest apparel. Modest apparel means you're not showing everything you got. You understand? You're not showing off your curves. What's the first thing our women do when they put on pants?
Teach.
They show. They look at their butt.
Right.
See how big their butt is.
Teach them.
Well, I'm gonna get a bunch of numbers today.
Let them know.
That's how our women dress.
Teach them.
That's the whole reason why they dress like that.
Teach them.
You're the reason why, sis.
Right?
So look up Zechariah chapter 11 and verse 5.
Whose possessors slay them?
Whose possessors slay them? Who are our possessors? Who brought us over here? Who owned our people? When you go to work at Safeway, if you work at Safeway, who do you work for? You work for the white man.
That's right.
That's your possessor.
That's right.
Read.
Whose possessors slay them?
Whose possessors slay them, read.
And hold themselves not guilty.
Hold themselves what?
Not guilty.
When they say court, when they kill our people?
Not guilty.
They hold themselves not guilty. You understand? They slay us. They kill us in the street.
Right.
And then when they go to court for it, what do they say?
Not guilty.
And guess what? You are the reason. of when the man came to Christ, he said, what is the greatest in the commandment? This is one of them. Read that.
Yes. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. Read it out. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
He said, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. How do you hate your brother?
I pray for him every day.
All right, read that.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
Okay, you pray for him, but do you rebuke him? You know what rebuke means? Means to correct him.
That's right.
Your brother, any.
I don't talk to him, and we don't have no communication.
I'm not talking about your direct blood brother. I'm talking about when you see a man, when you see one of your little brothers walking around with their pants down, sagging. When you see one of your little brothers or your little sisters being a whore in the street, do you correct them? Read. Hold on, read that over.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 7.
You just said correct them for what, right? Read.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
So if you don't rebuke your neighbor, you do what? You hate your brother.
That's right.
You hate them. You understand? You do. That's what the Bible says. Read it again.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him.
Don't allow them to sin.
That's right.
If you hate your brother, meaning you don't correct them, you're killing them.
Right.
Because eventually, they're going to die.
Right.
They're not going to repent.
Right.
Everlasting life.
Right.
They're going to die.
That's right.
You understand? So you're allowing them to walk on in darkness, to die. You understand? So that's the reason why you should correct them.
Right.
But get praying for them, because if you're praying for them and you're not doing the right things or setting the example, why should they do it?
Right.
If you're not wearing mouth apparel, why should the young sister wear mouth apparel?
That's right.
Right. Right. And why should the young sister wear mouth apparel? Give me, first, hold that and give me Matthew chapter 5.
Teach us.
Yep. Chapter 5. And verse 16.
Yeah.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light so shine before men. So God says, let your light shine before men. What is that talking about? What is the light that you're supposed to let shine before men? You know? Read that.
Proverbs chapter 6 and verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp.
So he said the commandment is a lamp. Read.
And the law is light.
And the law is light.
That's
so if you're keeping God's law, you're supposed to let that shine to everybody.
That's
you're supposed to let everybody see that you're keeping God's law. Because you blocked your space in the name of America, you are supposed to be keeping God's law.
That's right.
It's time to change your way.
Right.
You understand? So everything that you've learned here in America, it's time to subdue that.
Right.
It's time to come back to God's law. You understand that? Because this is your heritage. This is what God gave you to keep.
That's right.
You understand? So read that one more time in Matthew.
Matthew chapter 5 and verse 16.
You know what?
Let your light so shine before men.
So let your light so shine before men. If you're wearing a dress in modest apparel,
right,
and then you tell another young sister, sis, you're not supposed to dress like that. Now she can follow your example and
that's
say,
right.
You know what? I see that.
That's right.
You look beautiful in your dress. I'm going to start wearing dresses. I'm going to start putting on fringes. I'm going to start covering my head.
Right.
Because I'm an Israelite woman.
That's right.
I know my nationality now.
Right.
I know that I'm a child of God.
Right.
You understand? So that's why Christ said, let your light so shine before men.
That's
right. You understand? So now, when you do start keeping God's commandments and you pray for that sister, God will start hearing you.
That's right.
You understand? Because right now in your God does not hear you.
That's right.
And I'm going to show you that. Read.
Get out, Ike.
The book of John, chapter 9, and verse 31. Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
That God hears sinners.
That God heareth not sinners.
But what if I pray for somebody and I'm in the midst of sin?
God heareth not sinners.
God don't hear sinners, sis.
That's right. That's right. Therefore, if so be
understanding, meaning what you've already been taught from a youngster up until now. Read.
And reform your heart.
And reform your heart. Your heart is the mind. If you will reform your mind, meaning change it. Read.
You shall be kept alive.
You shall be kept alive. Because Christ is not coming to give out daisies and hugs and kisses. Christ has come to destroy. You understand me? You will be kept alive.
Right.
When Christ comes to destroy America, you will be kept alive. Why? Right. Because you have repented.
Right.
You have changed your mind.
Right.
You understand? You're not the rebellious sister that you used to be.
Right.
You repented. You put on a dress. You're wearing modest apparel.
That's
you know your nationality now. You understand? We are the men of the Lord come to teach you that.
That's right.
And the only reason why we can teach you that is because we have the understanding.
That's right.
How did we get the understanding? Give me Psalms chapter 111 and verse 10. How did we get the understanding to come and teach you? Because we can't teach you unless we're being role models. Unless we're doing it ourselves. You understand? We're not
going to
teach you something that we're not doing. Our sisters are dressed in modest apparel.
Right.
How's that? When you look on this sign, our sisters are dressed. These are our actual wives.
Right.
That's right.
That's right.
These are our actual wives and sisters, daughters, and all of that. These are the models on these pictures that you see. So we're not telling you to do something that we're not already doing.
That's right. Teach.
The book of Psalms, chapter 111 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So to fear God is the beginning of having wisdom.
That's right.
You have not known wisdom unless you fear God.
Right.
A good understanding.
A good what?
Understanding.
So to have a good understanding of what this Bible is talking about, you have to be doing what?
A good understanding. Have all they that do his commandments.
You have to be keeping the commandments to have an understanding of the Bible. You understand? So that's why we can come out here and teach you what to do to come back to God, because we have already doing it.
That's right.
You understand?
Teach. Right.
Like I said, our sisters are in modest apparel. These brothers are wearing beards on their face. These are the men of the Lord
that
you see before you. These are the prophets. You understand?
Bring it out, huh?
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates from all our YouTube channels. Shalom.